What's up, everyone? So today we have a question from Donnie Darko, who says, can I use I2P on Tails? And if yes, how can I install the program on the persistent volume? So you can. It's a pain to set up, but it is possible. I have done it before. So that said, I haven't recorded it and put it into this video. So, you know, just full disclosure, like, most people have been like, oh, it's clickbait. But I wanted to answer your question, and I wanted to let you know that this is something that I've been working on. I know a long time ago, DeSnake had actually written a script that allowed this to happen and put it on Dread, which is super cool. So I was looking at something like, you know, grabbing that, because I tried running it, it screwed everything up. But I wanted to grab that and try running it with the latest one, and then, you know, kind of troubleshoot it and go through it. That takes some time, obviously, to do. But that is a video that I plan on having, you know, come out. Now, that said, a lot of people love Tails, and, you know, me included, as well as Tor. But one thing to keep in mind is that, you know, if you're going to be using an operating system, I always advise that people, you know, use them for specific purposes. Tails, obviously, is a great, you know, system for anonymity. For I2P, and again, like, one thing I will say is this code's, you know, it's not been audited, so I completely understand the question. And I think actually this question was, you know, existed before Prestium, and Prestium is an operating system that is basically Tails for I2P. So it natively has that kind of, you know, amnesic option where it's a live disk that's meant for you to boot up and use. And, you know, but now as far as persistence goes, on Prestium, I'm not sure if that exists, but that would be the option that I would go with if I wanted to, you know, use it, and, you know, be able to hop on and hop off and have it be kind of like Tails where it's amnesic. Now that said, you know, if you are going to do that, I do also suggest that you run I2P in the background on whatever your main OS is, just to support the network. That way you're not hopping off and hopping on. And when you do exit out, that you exit out gracefully. You don't just close everything or, you know, turn the power off, because it does mess with the I2P network. And I think at the end of the day, because it's all of us who make that network up, you know, I like to kind of talk about those best practices when we discuss these things. Because it's important, because if any, you know, if everyone, you know, uses it when they need it, but they don't support it in any other way, it's not something that's going to last that long, you know? So I'm definitely a big proponent of that. And you guys know, I've had videos on, you know, how to just create a dedicated server and run it, you know, strictly for the purpose of, you know, aiding, you know, I2P, which does not, unlike Tor, does not have a massive governmental funding, you know what I mean? Like Tor has a surplus at the end of the year. If you look at their account sheets, like they have a surplus, whereas, you know, IGP is just decentralized, and I've never seen any of that with them. And they're funded by people like you and me, which is awesome. So if you got money, you know, donate some money. If you got time, you know, donate that. And you know, if you got knowledge for coding and stuff, donate that. And if you don't have that, you know, and you're like me, and it's like, man, I don't have money, you know, or time or programming knowledge, donate bandwidth, you know, that's the easiest one to do. Because none of us, you know, use 100% of our bandwidth all the time, even when we're, you know, totally not downloading torrents from IP torrents, you know, we're still not using 100% of it. So I think that's, you know, to me, it's just it's a worthwhile cause to donate to. Everything's end-to-end encrypted, so it's not like, oh, there's something on my computer. It's not even, you know, an issue. So there's that. It's pretty much, the answer is, you know, there is. I just haven't done a video on it yet, because it's kind of a convoluted process, and there are much simpler options out there that are readily available, like Prestium. But yeah, that's definitely something I'm going to be doing a video on in the future. But thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next video.